today, Dr. Khan, Khan Center for Cardiac Longevity. The question today is, do vitamins just make expensive urine? That's a common topic, common phrase from a doctor to a patient, maybe from in a lecture or a video that you listen to. Is that always the case? Well, I feel strongly no, that we should get our nutrition from our food, from our drink, things like green tea and red teas and black teas and such. But there are holes in our nutrition schedule. One of those holes can be getting enough folic acid. Folate and foliage have the same word. You get it predominantly from eating green leafies, so eat a ton of green leafies. But is there anything to taking extra folate? Well, number one, if you're eating fortified grains, which are in so many cereals and other foods, you're probably getting folate, because we know that women that are conceiving that take extra folate have a lower incidence of neural tube defects like spinal bifida. So there's a lot of folate out there, and pregnant women are taking supplements. But what about the rest of us? Well, in the last couple weeks, a major study from China in the American Journal of Medical Science said you can reduce overall your risk of stroke by 10%. This is not the first time this has been reported, but it's being reported again in a very large analysis of 60,000 people. Folic acid lowers risk of stroke by 10% overall. And in certain people, specifically those that drop their homocysteine level by 25% on the folate, or those that don't eat a lot of fortified grains rich in folic acid, are particularly benefiting 15 to 20% range. So check your grains, see if you have a multivitamin already there, see what's there. There is a controversy about folate, folic acid, foliage, and other forms. So eat the leafy greens. We all agree on that. But I would listen to a recent lecture by the woman who actually described and cloned the gene famous in folate, MTHFR, who said she didn't really care if you take the fancier versions or the folic acid. I actually prefer the fancier versions. So for example, this is a vitamin called homocysteine supreme. It lowers your homocysteine. That's a blood test I'd suggest you ask your doctor to draw once. Normal levels are under 10. Elevated levels actually predict reduced lifespan, and elevated levels that are very high should be treated because they probably are a genetic defect in the MTHFR gene, or possibly eating too much meat. But one capsule of this has 1200 milligrams of a fancy form of folate. This is a multivitamin I just happened to pull off the shelf. This has the more standard 400 micrograms of folic acid in a special form that's ideal no matter what your genetic predisposition is. So they're out there, and just want to point out, it's not just expensive urine. People would like to know how to reduce a risk of stroke by 10, 15, 20%. Know your blood pressure, know your blood cholesterol, your blood sugar, know if your rhythm is normal, know if your carotid arteries are clean, and a lot of other factors. Eat healthy every day. But there are times, like coenzyme Q10, like selenium, where there is strong evidence that there can be a benefit to you to making sure you're getting the nutrition you need. That's it. A stroke of good luck today, but not a stroke itself. Have a wonderful day, a healthy day, rich in green leafies.